evening and welcome to the 2019 All Shore Concert. Tonight you are in for a real treat with two fabulous directors. Our first director with the Junior All Shore is Miss Louise Anderson, and she is an assistant professor of music and the coordinator of music education at Salisbury University, Maryland. She holds a PhD in music education from Temple University in Philadelphia. Dr. Anderson has 35 years of teaching experience in grades K-12, encompassing all areas, general music classroom, instrumental, and string instruction and choral. In 2007, Dr. Anderson earned the distinction of becoming the National Board Certified Teacher in Early Adolescent Young Adulthood Music Education with a focus in choral music education. At Salisbury University, Dr. Anderson teaches music education methods courses, music technology, choral methods, class piano, and several general education music courses. She also sings with the Salisbury Choral and has recently helped to establish the new Salisbury University Children's Choir. Our senior all-shore conductor is Dr. Christopher Ryder, and he is the Director of Choral Activities and Associate Professor of Music at the University of Mary Washington in Fredericksburg, where he directs the UMW Choir, Chamber Choir, and the Fredericksburg Singers, as well as teaching classes in voice, conducting, and the relationships between music and society. He is also Minister of Music at Fredericksburg Baptist Church and has directed the Fredericksburg Community Chorus since 2008. Prior to joining faculty at UMW, he taught at Randolph-Macon College in Ashland, at Concord University in Athens, West Virginia, and in the Stafford and Spotsylvania County School Systems. He has also served as music and artistic director with the Marathon Music Ministries in Fredericksburg for more than 30 years. His work with these choirs has included tours and performances throughout the United States and Europe. Dr. Ryder has directed district, county, and regional choruses and frequently judges middle school and high school choral festivals throughout the United States. In May 2013, he had the opportunity to conduct the Choir of Royal Holloway, University of London, as part of the London Festival of Contemporary Church Music, conducting works by prominent American composers. He has also been active as a singer with the Chamber Choral of Fredericksburg and with the West Virginia Symphony Chorus. Dr. Ryder is proud to have received the entirety of his music education and training in the Commonwealth of Virginia. He holds a Bachelor of Arts in Music from Mary Washington College, where he completed majors in voice and viola and studied conducting with Dr. Stephen Burton. He holds a Master of Arts in Choral Conducting from George Mason University. We hope you enjoyed tonight's show. These students have worked tirelessly with these wonderful directors, and I know you will see a great show for this evening. Thank you all for coming out. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone.
My name is Louise Anderson. I have the privilege of working at Salisbury University as the coordinator for music education there. And an even bigger privilege before that is I've spent 30 years in public schools teaching everything you can think of that is music. I've always had a choir under my hands or my baton, and I just love working with voices. Middle school choir, I've spent many years with those folks, and also with high school too. And it's a real privilege to work with these people up here today. They've had a fantastic day. They've gotten stronger and stronger during the day instead of getting tired, which is amazing. The first two pieces on the program, the first one is Gloria, Gloria in Excelsis Deo. And the second piece is titled Aya Ngina. Both of these songs are songs of celebration, but they are both from very different cultures. So we hope you enjoy our first two pieces of celebration.
Thank you.
Summer, and whatever money you have at that point, that's supposed to tell you how well you're going to do for the rest of the year. Right? So you hear Jack of Diamonds mentioned in here, and the singer in this one, they didn't do so well because they lost all their money gambling. But this also has some scat singing in it. Do-ba-da-do-da-da-da. So we hear some of that as well. Lots of things going on here. So we present the cuckoo.
She's a pretty bird, she warbles as she flies. The next piece, the energy is going to come down just a little bit here. This is Dorme, Dorme. And the language, it may sound Spanish to you, but it's actually Ladino, which is part of a language that the Sephardic Jews in Spain would have been speaking. The text on this one, sleep, sleep, mother's little boy, free from worry and pain. Listen with joy to your mother's words, the words of Shema Yisrael. Sleep, sleep, mother's little boy, with the beauty of the words of Shema Yisrael. Is from a body of work by James Papuli, and his works are more about social changes and trying to make the world a better place. And in this one, Can You Hear? Is from a project called Sounds of a Better World. Small Voices Calling, a series of songs focusing on children, which examines the world and how small steps can be made to improve it. So when he, with this piece, he was working with the choir as a commissioned work, but the children helped in putting it together too. So we hope you enjoy Can You Hear?
I am calling out to
quick stage change.
Junior choir's leaving, senior choir's coming.
Thank you. together about a composer by the name of Handel. We had to discuss some things about Handel. One of the things we learned is that Handel was a composer from Germany. Though he is often considered to be an English composer, he spent the bulk of his career in England writing for English audiences. So even though he is technically a German composer, he's considered one of the most popular English composers that there was. This is Hallelujah, Amen. As I've said, this weekend we've learned a lot of music and we've learned a lot about one another. I do want to make sure that you fully appreciate, as we do, the work of Professor Susan Zimmer over there on the piano, who has been so marvelous. This next song is loosely based on a poem by William Shakespeare. That was then adapted by some other poets, one Henry Heveningham. And it's about music, but it's also about the enjoyment of life. We've talked this last couple of days about what it means to sense, to feast on our senses, to really feast on enjoying the things that are happening, what we see, what we feel, what we smell and what we taste. We hope that you'll get a sense of that. I think we really enjoy singing this. I know I enjoy waving my arms in front of them while they sing it. They seem to really enjoy it. This is David Dickhouse, If Music Be the Food of Love. Thank you. We had the opportunity to put both of these groups together for just a little bit today. We had kind of a rare opportunity this afternoon also in that we got to meet a living composer, Anthony Corey Williams, who composed this next piece. We found him on FaceTime on this machine right here. He listened to us sing and then gave us some encouraging words. I think that was a really fun experience. He was thrilled to have so many young people singing this piece. This is a piece that asks a question in many ways and leaves us hanging with that question at the end. You will hear that question not only in the voices, but in the way the music is written, in the parts that are played by the piano, in all of it. The summary of that is this: if I could see beyond this day, would I live a better way?
Thank you.
asked to choose combined pieces, and independently we chose pieces that are both inspiring and more about the world and people coming together. This last and final piece on the program is We Are One. And I think the title really says it all for this piece. And there are so many ways in our world that people are being separated and categorized, and there's lots of negativity out there. But we need to pull ourselves back to thinking about just who are we, and we are one.